Hi, this is Dr. Scott Hoar. Today is Treatment Tuesday, and this week our patient is Emily Piercy. Emily comes to us from Blount Memorial Hospital System right here in Maryville, Tennessee. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do you got going on?
Well, I've been having some hip pain post-surgery. Had surgery on labral tear repair in December.
Of 2019.
Okay. So a little less than a year. Just a little bit of achiness with it, a little unsure.
Okay, so looking at her x-rays and her examination, what we saw was a little bit of scoliosis of her middle back and her lower back, where there's rotation of a number of the different segments, and sometimes there's some squiggling of the spine, which opens the door to just compensatory movements throughout the body. So we'll take a look at a bunch of stuff. Some noteworthy limitations: her neck rotating to the right was pretty darn limited. And you know, if you have one part of your body that doesn't move well, that compensates and makes the rest of your body move abnormally. So we're gonna look at her neck movement. She did mention that during the assessment she had a bit of a shoulder injury at one point, a fracture and a what?
Labral tear.
And a labral tear. So we'll look at some of that sort of stuff. And then the big thing is really the hip, the right hip. She had labral surgery and she's looking to recover from that, and it was impacted during whole body rotation, during squatting, and any time she's trying to really stabilize and engage her hip. So we'll look at all that stuff and see what we can do for it. So what I'm doing right now is called motion, and I'm just feeling for the motion at the end range of any of the joints.
Okay.
What we notice when we do the lower cervical here, there's some nice bounce and give.
Mm-hmm.
When we go over here, difference.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I'm going to do an adjustment on. Okay.
Okay.
You comfortable with that?
Yes.
So we'll go right here and then I'll adjust that right there. Very good. And now we go back to the motion palpation.
Yeah.
And you'll see it's cleaned up that motion.
Absolutely.
So the C2 is the main vertebrae responsible for rotation. So I'm going to take you right over here and do a manipulation there. Good. And we'll look right into rotation. And it's not perfect, but it's a whole lot better, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Good. All right. Now, we're going to jump into some muscle tests. Good?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Make it this. So I'm going to do a bunch of muscle tests, and that's going to tell me what's working and what's not working about your body as far as what I need to treat.
Okay.
So we'll start right here. Make a fist for me. What I'm going to do is push your elbow down to the table. Your goal is not to win, but just resist whatever pressure I put into it, okay?
Okay.
Pushing down, don't let me. Ready? Again? That's perfect.
Okay.
Now put your thumb and your pinky together. I'm going to pull them apart. Don't let me. Come on. All right, so a little bit weak there.
Okay.
So the nerve roots that control those muscles come out about the C8 nerve root, C8 and T1.
Okay.
So the lower part where the neck meets right there. So I'm gonna grab that segment. And do an adjustment. Sometimes there's nice releases during an adjustment. Sometimes there's not.
Okay.
Put your thumb and your pinky, pulling apart. And you see, even without a pop or a crack,
mm-hmm.
we stimulated that nerve to have a reset button.
Wow.
Where it restored normal motor control of your hand.
Okay.
And that's what tells us that we're actually improving your function.
Okay.
Bring your elbow in at your rib cage. I'm gonna pull it out like that. Resist that motion. Very strong. Make a fist, I'm gonna push down. Don't let me. Very strong. Which, it was the left one, wasn't it? So, make a fist here. I'm gonna push your elbow down.
Okay.
Resist that motion. Again. Not so strong, huh?
Not so strong.
All right, so that's the crocobrachialis
muscle,
and a lot of the innervation from that comes out of your lower neck. So we're gonna adjust right there. Make a fist, pushing down. Lot stronger. Any irritation?
No.
All right, good. Thumb and pinky, pulling that apart. Don't let me. Not so good.
Goodness.
Thumb pinky, pulling apart. Not so good, okay. Now, this is not terribly surprising for a massage therapist. Mm-hmm. Hand and wrist dysfunction, which is, that's a lot of what we're looking at with that. Not great. So, then we'll go in here and adjust some of your carpals and some of your phalanges there. Do you ever have wrist issues?
I've had a carpal out before, and it was killer. I had to go to the physical therapist downstairs and have him try to get it in.
Yeah. Thumb and pinky, pulling apart. There you go. If you didn't, you'd be about the only massage therapist ever to not have wrist problems. That's pretty good. Elbow in at your rib cage. I'm going to pull it out like that. Resist my motion. And that's just not the same, is it?
Mm-mm.
All right. Deep breath for me. Breathe on out. There we go. Elbow in here. Ready? Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to pull it out like that. Don't let me.
And that's a lot stronger, isn't it?
Better.
Good. I'm going to push out that way.
Okay.
Resist me. Keep that elbow locked. I'm going to stabilize your body here.
Okay.
Ready? And that is not great. Okay, so that's looking at your major muscle. So what we're going to do...
So I'm going to do an adjustment right over here.
Pushing that way. Don't let me. And good... But not perfect, right?
Okay.
So now we're going to go down where these anterior ribs.
Right there.
This tender?
Tender. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because you probably had a lot of stuff going on there for a long time.
Mm-hmm. And good.
Pushing it that way. Don't let me. A lot better with that pec major firing, right?
Huh.
So that's
going to
support your shoulder girdle, front and back, a little bit more. Put your chin to your chest. Breathe out. Again, chin to chest. Sit up your head like a sit-up. Ooh, we're going to have to get that from another...
I feel like
the other angle.
Past chiropractic care, that area, if I remember, would stick a lot.
Yeah.
They would try.
And it wouldn't go great? Well, flip around on your belly then. Let's see what we can... Nice knot there, huh?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Yeah, you definitely have some stiff spots. Take a deep breath for me. Breathe on out. Deep breath. Breathe out. There we go. That'll help to open up the extension of your whole rib cage and your thoracic spine there.
I know I've asked you this a million times. It's the left hip.
It's the left hip.
Okay. And that's when I can tell it's not,
it catches kind
not
of,
quite.
Yeah.
Normal.
All right. So when we internally rotate your right hip, there's a nice amount of range of motion. And then as soon as we internally rotate this hip, range of motion is not terrible, but you can feel all your irritation.
Mm-hmm.
Do you feel it there too?
Not too bad. It's a little bit in the back, but it's mostly the internal rotation.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, right there.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
So we're going to do an adjustment right to the deep hip capsule. I'm going to put my speeder board underneath you. A little bit more. And that sticky spot is right there, right?
Yeah, right there.
Uh-huh. All right, so what I'm going to do is put a force right through the hip to mobilize it.
Okay.
Good. Let's get one more in here. Good. Good. Post-check. Range is definitely better.
Yeah.
How does it feel?
I don't feel it catching.
Good.
Which is interesting.
Beautiful. All right. Okay, so we mobilized your hip. We have more range of motion in that hip.
Okay.
Now let's check just general stability of the lower half. So I'm going to do a muscle test.
Okay.
I'm going to push down like so.
Okay.
Resist that motion.
Okay.
Ready? And not amazing. Pushing down here. Ready?
Yeah.
And again, even worse. Let's try this one again. Pushing down. At least there's some fight.
Yes.
And the left side's got no fight. So that's looking at your hip flexors.
Okay.
Okay, which are obviously an important part of moving your hip.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to adjust the L2 segment where the nerve roots from there control a lot of those hip flexors.
Okay.
So turn on your side, face
towards
me.
You.
Yeah. Deep breath. Breathe out. Good. Muscle test. Pushing down. Don't let me. Big difference, huh?
Huge difference.
Let's go back to your other one. Pushing down. And that's rock solid, too. So now we've got our hip flexors back in the game.
Okay.
That's great. I'm going to do a muscle test where I push down and in.
Okay.
Resist that motion. And not so much, huh? Down and in.
Yeah,
no. Not so much. All right. All right. Muscle test. What I'm going to do is straighten your leg down like that.
Okay.
Don't let me do that. Very strong. Other side. Pushing down. Don't let me. Again. And that's not great, but I want to check your hip extensors. So raise your knee up. I'm going to push your knee into the table. Resist that motion. Very rock solid strong. Knee up. Pushing down. And that's really rock solid strong too. So there's the hamstring test.
Yeah.
Pushing down. That's pretty strong. Pushing down. And you got nothing. And breathe out. Good. Muscle test, pushing down. Good. And pushing down. There we go. A lot stronger.
Yeah.
All right. Good job. All right, it's the left hip.
Left.
Dorsiflexion's fine here. You got, so bunion's worse on the right.
Mm-hmm. And I do have a chronically twisted ankle on my right from an injury when I was like 10 or 12.
Interesting, because the dorsiflexion is limited, but it's not, like it's better than mine.
Okay.
Left dorsiflexion's good. Toe extension's not terrible. Little bit of flat feet.
Mm-hmm.
Not awful stuff, though. I'm going to give your foot a little yank here.
Okay.
Try your best to hold onto the table, because it'll slide. Yeah, right there. Good. I'm going to give you another yank here. Good. And one more. Okay. Switch feet for me. Last one. Good. Straighten your feet. Dorsiflex your ankles and pop your pelvis up. Good. How does that feel?
I'm shaky.
Okay. And I'm going to push down here. Resist the motion.
Pretty
good. And no pain or discomfort.
Not pain. Hmm.
Flip around.
Weakness.
Head here, feet there.
This will be interesting.
Yeah.
I remember earlier in hip surgery or pre-surgery, I could not do a plank on this side very well because of the hip.
Mm-hmm.
So same thing?
Yep. Okay, before we get into any testing, is there any discomfort?
I feel some tension here in my hip, but not
tension, made. But not
tension,
pain.
Not pain, just tension.
All right. Pop again. I'm going to push down, resist that motion. And it's hard for you to deal with that.
Yep.
Okay. Well, let's do this. We really want those lateral stabilizers present for healthy hips. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap this around here. And I'm going to pull backwards.
Okay.
I want you to pop up into the same exact position you just were. Good. And me pulling back obviously turns on a whole different bunch of muscles. And I'm going to push down and resist that. And you're stronger now, aren't you?
Feels stronger. It still is fatigued there or tight. But yes, I do feel stronger.
Let's try a different angle. Pop up in your pelvis. And resist that. You feel the engagement going on? I'm pushing down. That's probably even better, yeah?
That's better, yeah.
All right, good. So what you're going to do is you're going to pop up. You're going to be dorsiflexed. I want your hand pushing up towards the ceiling.
Okay.
And we're just going to make sure you're really engaged and doing awesome stuff. 10-second reps.
Okay.
So pop up. The first exercise we had you do was the side plank, where you had weakness on the one side. So we did an engagement where I pulled your body forward. And when I pulled it forward, you had to engage that posterior chain, your glutes, and just the whole posterior chain to help stabilize a lateral stability event. What was that like for you?
I was surprised at how weak I was, although knowing that after surgery that was my weak side, but that band helped engage so much more was interesting. How would you replicate that on your own?
So, I mean, given somebody like you that works in a fitness center, it would be very, very easy. You can just take a band of any kind and you'll have to attach it to a wall.
Okay.
So some sort of wall attachment or maybe a bar or something like that and wrap it around your body and have it pulled back.
Okay.
What I want you to do. Flip around hands and knees. Spread your knees out. Curl your toes under. And squat. Yeah. And back up. The second exercise, where really we're just doing a squat from a kneeling exercise.
Okay.
The purpose of that was to get all the, you know, your core neutral and firing while you were getting hip flexion and knee extension, all the things that are involved with a squat. And then we got you over here, and you were able to actually do a little bit more of a normal squat. My advice to you was to widen your feet and turn your feet out, because I think that's a more neutral positioning for your hip sockets.
Okay.
We're all designed with different hip sockets. Some people, a perfect squat is kind of a narrow stance with feet forward.
Right.
Some people need to turn it out a little bit more. When you spread your feet out and turned them out, you should have seen your spinal column. It was completely neutral.
Okay.
It was so much easier for you. When you're narrow, your whole thing falls forward and you can no longer have a neutral supported spine and torso. And given kind of some of your scoliosis and some of the alignment issues, you want to be doing exercises that keep your spinal column
the other
neutral
direction.
And
I mean, I did feel this engaged a lot.
In a good way or a bad way?
I mean, in a good way, but like I'm not feeling it on this side. Like I don't feel like I have to tighten it.
So how's that feel?
It feels good. I don't really feel any stiffness or restrictions.
Good. What I would tell you, though, just regarding your squat technique, is I think you're a little bit narrow. And you're leading to kind of that skier's kind of posture. I think, why don't you try it turned wider, turned out, and see if you can stay a little bit more upright with your spine. There you go. And you could tell when her lumbar spine loses neutrality. That's right there. Mm-hmm. And you feel that?
I have paid attention to it enough to know that I probably don't typically go that deep.
So go down slow, and I'll tell you when to stop. Go, 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 stop. And from right there, kind of engage and jump out of it powerfully. Ooh. Okay, good. So we're going to do one of those martial arts kind of...
Okay.
You're going to just fire, and that's going to pressurize all your system here so that you can have the stability to stay neutral while coming out of it. So come on down. Pause, and come on out. Good. And again. And up. Perfect. Still difficult. Do it to the right side.
But... to me, that was a lot better. I don't feel...
So that was her treatment. Emily, how did that go for you?
Surprisingly well. I mean, I was a little nervous about the hip, just with it being not even a year after surgery, and it feels a lot better.
Yeah.
And it didn't hurt. Well, there was a tiny twinge, but it didn't hurt like I thought it was going to hurt.
Good.
When you mentioned the scoliosis, is there anything... post-treatment that I should be doing on a regular basis to keep that engaged or...
Yeah, believe it. The number one thing I would have you do is those side planks.
Okay.
That lateral stability of your hip is what supports not just the hip socket, but your whole frame.
Okay.
All right? So number one is that. There are also a number of other exercises that we didn't go over today that really help you stay balanced. When it comes to, we talked about your thoracic spine, that's a little bit stiff, and you could make sure the thoracic spine is moving great to the right as well as the left, and that's going to be another thing that helps you stay as balanced as possible.
Okay.
Knowing full balance is not a possibility. It's not real.
Right.
Nobody is 100% balanced from one side to the other. But the goal is to fight that fight.
Right.
To support your body as much as you can as we age.
Right.
Okay. All right.
Well, I appreciate it.
Thank you so much for coming in and being a great sport in front of the camera here.
Okay.
That was Treatment Tuesday. Tune in for next Treatment Tuesday next week. I'm Dr. Scott Hoar. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, the like button, and leave a comment below. Thanks so much.